right. I am still filming in New York and thought I would show you a little bit more of the skyline and just how tall everything is behind me. Oh my goodness, I have no idea how tall that building is, but I know I am on the 15th floor, and so who knows, that might be a 50-story building. It's crazy, especially because I usually have 20 acres plus of rolling hills behind me, and so here I am in the city. It is always nice to get a little change of pace. I'm always happy to go home to be away from the sound, the bustle, hustle and bustle of the city, but I do love getting to experience both. So today's post was about power. And I happen to know that a friend who watches these regularly, that is her word of the year. So I'm pretty excited to think about how we connect over power. I was reflecting this morning about the times in my 8 months of sobriety that I have not felt happy, joyous, and free. I tend to beat myself up over situations where I can't free myself from negative emotions. Still true today. I decided to write down the times when I struggled the most and expected the list to be overwhelmingly long. But really, I can boil it down to two themes: resentment against control freaks, snowball thinking, or feeling overwhelmed. Narrowing it down to two common themes gave me back some of my power. I can't control other people, places, or things, but I can now more easily identify my triggers and, with divine help, manage my reaction. My fallback in tough times is always the serenity prayer. I know there are so many things in this world I cannot control, but it doesn't mean I have to feel weak. I cannot use the excuse that nothing matters and that I coast through life at the mercy of the world or that people can walk all over me. In recovery, we have the ability to set boundaries and to control our reactions. Exercise that right. Fill the day with power. And boy, do I think about how these couple of things can still have an effect on me. I definitely have let go of my resentment of control freaks, and in early sobriety, I learned the phrase, "If you spot it, you got it," which I never wanted to be true, but it almost always was. So when I was getting frustrated by control freaks, I realized it's because I was one for so many years of my life. I micromanaged everything, projects, teams, my own life, coming up with like 100-day workout programs and writing it all in my calendar and then getting mad at myself when I couldn't stick to that habit every single day. Just like I really had to give myself grace when I took a couple of weeks off from this exercise. It is important to step into our power, both for setting boundaries with others, but also setting boundaries for ourselves. And I had to say, hey, enough is enough, I have to take a break. And that was okay. My sponsor always said no is a complete sentence. And so I try to live by that, even though I no longer go to 12-step meetings. A lot of the language I use in these videos is 12-step related from when I spent a couple of years going to meetings. It is absolutely the foundation of my sobriety and the reason that I am about to celebrate 5 years sober. I hope that you are learning how to own your power in whatever personal growth journey you are on. I would love to hear what that looks like for you. Please drop it in the comments, subscribe to the channel, and I look forward to seeing you with a new daily affirmation very soon.